the first vlog on OTT and its relationship with OTA. Quick summary of what that means is OTT, of course, is services like Netflix, Prime, Disney Plus, and Select TV from Freecast. OTA is broadcast, specifically over-the-air television, and how those two work together. Now, there have been three major developments with OTA over the last decade. And one of them started with the digital transition in the late 2000s, where television went from analog to digital, and then they opened up a window for thousands and thousands of construction permits for low-power television stations, which are the same as the big full-power television stations, just a smaller signal. Then the next thing that happened was just a few years later, they had the spectrum auction, where they were going to sell lots and lots of television spectrum and then repack all the television stations into a smaller section of spectrum. Now, all of a sudden, you had all these thousands and thousands of construction permits for these low powers, but then you had an auction that was threatening to take them away. So the FCC waived the build-out timetable. You had a certain amount of time from when you had a construction permit to actually build the TV station. So the FCC said, you know, it's not fair to basically make you build out this TV station and then maybe you're going to lose it. So all of a sudden, all these low power operators had an opportunity to wait and see what happened with the auction. The auction took place, they repacked all the big full powers, and then the low power started to have timetable. Once again, you have to build these stations out. Now, a lot of them, what they did is they started to build them temporarily and then shut them down, ask for what is called silent authority. Now, the final build out is supposed to take place next year, 2022. But all of a sudden, the FCC is saying, oh, you can't build it out and then make it silent. And that's going to put everything at risk. I mean, literally thousands of potential new TV stations that could be coming online in the next several years, and tens of thousands of sub-channels could just not exist. Why is that important? That is important because of the third development that's happened in the last decade. And I was part of making this happen, which was when the auction took place, the low power guys came and said, look, you can't call us dinosaurs and use that as an excuse to take away our spectrum and then not let us evolve. It's time for a new television standard called ATSC 3.0. And that's already being put into development. So think of it as you have this huge beachfront property and the opportunity to build all these buildings on the beachfront that could make lots and lots of money. And now all of a sudden, people are coming in and saying you can't build those buildings. Or you have to build these buildings in the next year or else. And so there's this huge opportunity in the OTA space, the over-the-air space, to have all these sub-channels that can utilize this new television standard. Now, I can't get into why that is important on this vlog, but luckily we're going to have one of these every week, and I'm going to, over the next several weeks, talk about the new television standard. And the other question you might be asking is, why should we in the OTT world care about the OTA world? Well, you don't look at OTA as a competitor. You need to look at OTA as a sibling. There's opportunities to work together. They're important to each other. And again, in future vlogs, we're going to deal with what are the opportunities, and specifically, what are the opportunities for Select TV to work with the OTA world? So you have all these things that have been happening over the last decade, and we have to care deeply about what the FCC is doing now. Because it's just simply not fair because the supply chains are all backed up. There are a lot of stations that just simply are not going to meet this deadline. and we need to get the FCC to change its mind on this. Anyway, stay tuned over the next few weeks as we talk about the exciting ways that OTA and OTT are going to work together to change the dynamic of entertainment for the next several decades.